Hey, everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Place, the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. We're at 25. I'm feeling excited, but we can't let our guard down. You never know if 26, the Boxing Day run, is going to sneak up behind you and give you the Halo and also Forget Me Now. And decent starting stats, but Wiggle Worm, or Ringworm, is a little scary. KA8VD2LZ. Weird. This is weird. We have a number of different courses of action to take. I really don't want to let my guard down right off the bat. That being said, I am going to use Ringworm, because I don't actually believe this, but I think for flavor purposes, it's kind of funny to be like, well, you know, we'll make a sacrifice when it comes to our trinket. It gave us a bad trinket, and we'll stick with it in the hopes that this is like penance for us getting the all stats upgrade so that the universe remains in karmic balance, you know? I will say with our range, or shot speed, I'm not sure which one it actually is, it's kind of fucking up my ability to actually hit enemies with this because of the fact that my shots are just too dang fast. They're coming in from like the other side of the screen. They're making a huge loop on their rotation here. They're hitting walls. I think I may, if I've ever had an excuse to drop Ringworm early, this is a pretty decent one in that we really can't hit enemies that are directly in front of us. But I'm holding out hope that maybe there's a chance we pick up like a, you know, an early Brimstone or something and this is hilarious. But for now, we're clearly not there. Got a bomb. There was a tinted rock, but I don't think it was a tinted rock in a position that we were liable to hit. So, I mean, you probably know what my strat is when it comes to Forget Me Now. We have to ignore the blank card if we're going to make this work. But I think if you have a key, 100% you use blank card on the second floor. If you don't have a key, we could use it after this boss to guarantee ourselves an item room on the next floor. And I think that may be what I actually endeavor to do here. Like, just beat Monstro and then pop it and see how it works. That also gives us one extra floor to get over 5 cents. It does minimize our chances of getting as many deals with the devil. It lowers our effective deal with the devil count, or expected deal with the devil count, because we're using a duplicate floor that can't give us a deal with the devil. But I think there's a case to be made that this is still a reasonably good option. We'll see what we get from this boss, though. I'm definitely dropping Ringworm. Like, this is getting a little silly here. Being able to shoot straight makes me appreciate our DPS that much more. Thank you, Ringworm, for showing up, adding a little bit of flavor to the start here, Craig Mack style, but sure, we'll take Blood Clot. Let's do it. I think we'll redo the first floor, see if we can get super stacked by the second floor. And this is Curse of the Labyrinth, so it sort of worked out okay, I guess? We can't get into that room, but that's very likely to be a library. Oh my god, we got a nickel. Right off the bat here, we got a red chest. This is a guppy item. It's not, but if it were, that'd be amazing. Perks is good to know. Bad gas, similarly, good to know. Sad bombs is a pretty solid item here, and that's gonna be a ridiculous... Oh no. I didn't fuck it up, thankfully. We got the tinted rock, and a ton of money here. Oh, we didn't quite get the second one there. Is it worth a bomb for 6 cents? I'd say probably yes. I don't really want to bomb the wooden nickel. Apparently 6 cents is my threshold. 5 cents? No way, man. No way, no how. 6 cents? Might as well. But we are at 23 cents. That makes a difference as well, you know. The expected, I thought that was bad gas again. You'd rather use a bomb to get money when you have less money. Most of the time, I'd say. So we got Balls of Steel. That's fantastic, of course. We're as close to, like, rolling as you can realistically be this early on in a run, you know? Sad Bombs is great, Blood Clot is fine, Halo's good, we're stacked on resources. We have one extra item room already attached to this run that we wouldn't have normally had. Might as well go shop and library. We know that we're gonna be able to get an active item in our library, if it is a library. Deep Pockets is totally fine. See what we got going on down here first. It doesn't really matter if we go to our library before we go to the devil room, because if there's an active item on a deal with the devil, we're going to want it anyway for precedence. So let's go see what we got in here. It's going to start with Duke of Flies. Sad Bombs should make pretty short work of that. Get range plus luck. It's okay. The luck is the big deal there. And then you know what? Sad Bombs may make pretty short work of Larry Jr. as well. Three dead with one bomb will save our other ones, obviously. We get HP up, which I probably shouldn't have taken yet. But we had no precedent options in here anyway. So do you take Curse of the Tower? Especially with Sad Bombs, Curse of the Tower can be both dangerous and sort of fun. Friends till the end, another Balls of Steel is great. we are worse off now as a result of the fact that we don't have Deal with the Devil precedent. I mean, I guess we never had Deal with the Devil precedent, but we would have expected to get it here. So I do feel like we're slightly worse off now, but certainly not in a bad position. With one key left, we want to check out our potential library. It is a library. Probably go Satanic Bible. Book of Revelations gives us the orbitals, at least the better chance of the orbitals, but I think you probably go Satanic Bible for the Demon Hearts. But apart from that, this is great. We still got one more item room left to go here as well. We've got a top tier... Oh, we got a curse room as well. We got a top tier space bar item. We got some really good passive items. We don't have Deal with the Devil precedent, but you know what? Maybe this makes this prime for like a perfect angel room or something like that. Angel room run, I should say. We also have a lot of HP, which we didn't necessarily start with a little, but we didn't start with a ton either. Mom's wig or go hard on a reroll? I'm gonna go hard on a reroll here. Zodiac, I don't think is good enough. Mom's pad at least contributes to the mom transformation. Book of Shadows knocks another book out of the rotation. But it's not what we want. I'll take Inner Eye. And there's... People probably would have preferred to see Mom's... well, they would think that Mom's wig is maybe better than... Triple Shot. But I like Triple Shot decently enough. I'm also gonna get... You know what? I'll get a 3-cent bomb. I was thinking maybe... buy a key, but there's no key for sale. Got a decent amount of money for the next floor. We'll head down. We're also like right on time despite doing one extra floor or part of an extra floor. It's kind of a weird scenario, but all right. Yes, 9 lives is very good. More than happy to have this. We could wait to pick this up until the end of the floor. Do we gain much out of that? Well, we do if there's a deal with that. We could possibly gain a decent amount out of it, but we only lose 1 HP for doing this, so I don't think that's bad. We lose 1 HP and then multiply our remaining lives by 9, so well worth it. Not really, unlike the last run, not really, like, hinging all of my chances of victory on actually picking up the Guppy transformation, but of course, 9 lives in a vacuum is nice to have, and we are going to actually get, you should not have hit me. It's going to be bad for you. But we, oh my god, we killed them out of order, so we didn't get the left hand. I was gonna say that I got me pretty excited about the left hand. This early on gives us a much better chance to become Guppy. You know, teleportations to the Devil Room. Even just picking up something like Bob's Curse synergizes nicely with Sad Bomb's Curse of the Tower. But life goes on. Still happy we did the room right on schedule. We might actually be able to experience Boss Rush. And where do I set my sights now? I mean, after 25 wins, we gotta take a step back and honestly, without being too cocky, give ourselves a little pat on the back. It's not a, you know, gargantuan Cobalt Streak-esque pat on the back yet. It's just like a dinky little Northern Lion-sized pat, but we're getting there, you know? Still like 90 wins in a row away from the best streak I ever had. 90-ish anyway, it's a long way. It's gonna take us a long time to get there. But I got faith that if we just, you know, play our cards right, don't lose our sight of zaniness, but at the same time, you know, you get a lot more room for error when it comes to potentially being able to lose when you're making the right plays on the field, despite, you know, maybe making some zany decisions in your brain. I don't know if that makes any sense. It may not. But what I'm saying is, if I dodge well, our margin of error for winning goes way up. Way up, I think. Way down. It goes in the good direction. What you feel the good direction is may depend on your own personal choices there. I will say, rate of fire a little lower than I'd like. Or, conversely, you know, maybe damage a little lower than I'd like. But we got a lot of things going for us right now. And if we can get the Guppy Dream completed on this floor or the next floor, I'll be stoked. We got another reroll machine. That's a tough choice. I don't really want Sissy Longlegs, even though it's not bad. Okay, Counterfeit Penny is a pretty good trinket, especially if we're going to be using money to reroll so many donation machines. With no bombs, we've got to be a little bit more prudent about how we handle our donation machine, I think. Or how we handle our reroll room. Come on. You got to be one hit away. Stop doing these 90 degree turns here. There we go. All right, we got a pill. Pill is range down. Honestly, not that bad. Diplopia is pretty big. I think we go, but we won't have enough money to get Diplopia if we do that. It's a tough call, man. You know what I'm looking for now? We're going to do some creative plays. So creative, I don't even want to tell you. I want you to have a chance to suss it out for yourself. And then we'll talk about it as I get ready to do it. And these bombs are going to enable me to do that. So here's the Northern Lion's secret right here. Oh, careful. We're going to go in here, and I'm going to say, you know, my apologies to the donation machine. Because I'm going to hope to get a decent amount of cash out of you right here. We could have used our bombs to accomplish what I'm trying to accomplish here, but this is one other way out of this strat for sure. So what do we got here? 34 cents. Then we're going to buy Diplopia, and now we're going to engage in a little bit of a little roulette slot machine style action here. Okay, Capricorn, no doubt. Do you double Capricorn? Yes. But what I was thinking we could have done is actually pick it up, and then we get another item by using Diplopia. But I think doubling Capricorn, even if it doesn't give us two times the damage multiplier, is at least going to give us two times the stat upgrades that are not damage. And as such, I think that this is almost certainly the most sensible choice for us here. Seems good to me, at least. Okay, we haven't fought Pestilence yet. Even despite ignoring the... Despite ignoring Book of Revelations, or at least not taking it with us here, it has opted to still say thank you, still reward us with a cube of meat. I'm happy to have it. That's another interesting option for the Diplopia, for sure, but I think we still won out here. Glad we saved the bomb. One cube of meat, we come up here. Another interesting option for Diplopia. Could have used it to get a couple of extra item pedestals in here, which might have actually been better than a second Capricorn that's not doing too much for us right now, maybe, but this gives us the chance for the angel plays, and also, I'm a big fan of Holy Light as an angel item. We're just continuing to kind of stack up the advantages here. I don't want to milk our donation machine too hard. Oh, God. Yep. I had a feeling this could happen. Got an Eternal Heart out of it, hilariously enough. It actually sort of worked out for us. We got the value out of the blood bag without actually needing to, well, we got some of the value out of the blood bag, because we definitely didn't get all the money that we would have gotten, but life goes on. Another luck upgrade. Is luck a determining factor in Holy Light? If it is, well, I'm just as pleased as punch, but if it's not, I mean, it's still good. I can't frame it as if it's like some kind of catastrophic problem, but... Oh my god, okay. Curse of the Tower. Starting to wear out its welcome a little bit, I'll admit. Doesn't help that I've been hit a ridiculous amount on this floor, but we're still going strong. Don't worry, one makes you small is fine. What am I going to do with... Oh my god, we're going to reroll our whole run? Absolutely we are. Take the key. Reroll everything. We got Yes Mother. Eden's Blessing, like, conjoined, marked. This, and Isaac's Heart. Oh, fantastic. This is horrible. This is actually awful. I can sort of shoot straight with marked if I plan my day right, but it's not easy. Oh my god, why are you messaging me on Steam? This is a little silly here. I haven't gotten a Steam message in years. Unless it's from my long-lost uncle. I don't want to know it right now, man. Okay, there you go. Just do that. What am I even looking for at this point? I mean, Tractor Beam maybe provides us with some quality. Can I talk about how we still have Curse of the fucking Tower? Why do we still have Curse of the Tower? Thank God for Rotten Baby, man. Mom's bra. Hey, it's something. Mom's key. I don't think we need to get a key. I'm starting to get a little anxious here. I'm not overly... What? Oh, Isaac's Heart got hit, of course. I'm not outrageously concerned with a loss at this point, because we still do have, you know, 9 lives, a Guppy item, decent HP. But I am sort of banking on the idea of a... of a full-run reroll at this point, sadly. I'm really not a huge fan of marked, and then let's combine this with the fact that I actually have to aim it at a fucking 45-degree angle in order to hit anything. Not an enormous fan of that either. Come on, Rotten Baby. You got the knowledge to get into college here. Thank you. Dry Baby's helping out a ton. I appreciate that. I guess we're just supposed to stand here and block the shots. It's gonna be a learning process. I'm not gonna lie to you. Sure, evil rain, shot speed. I mean, the shot speed could be helpful, but everything else a little suspect. I need an ability to fly or something like that. Hook me up. What do we got in here? Red chest. One red chest. I put my faith in the game, and I was betrayed. Enemies that rush us down are the real problem. Enemies that just shoot, who cares? Enemies that rush us are the real issue here. Make sure we're shooting at all times. We got to get Rotten Baby in there. We got to block all these incoming shots. Nice, nice. Look at that. Balls of steel. Battery charge. That's worth very little. You know what? We got to roast and toast this guy right now. Helps if you're actually able to shoot. You're gonna look at this and be like, how is this dude fucking up his shot so badly? I gotta tell you, it's a little harder than it looks to aim these right now with conjoined and marked. If this run was like a D6, or not a D6, but a 6 room, I would have bounced ASAP. I would have been out. It wouldn't even be close. Excuse me. You gotta watch out because Isaac's heart is involved here. Okay. And I think it's really a major mistake to look at this run right now and be like, look at all that HP, you're sorted. That's not how she goes here. Don't shoot it. Nice, secret room. Battery, not great, but maybe we'll get a library in the future. You know, that's transient, man. Le transant. It's not a guarantee that the run's gonna go well just because you got a decent amount of HP right now. You know, you really got to worry about the future. I'd much rather have a reliable means to deal damage and a lot less HP. Come on, can you just actually, like, shoot in this direction? Without Rotten Baby, we'd be in a much scarier position. But this is definitely, like, on the low-end theory for rerolls here. Small rooms are the real scary part. Give me some mapping or some like homing tears, some piercing shots, some little brim damage or something like that. Our rate of fire is pretty good, and actually our damage is not horrible once we can actually line it up, but I think, yeah, there you go. We got a new methodology here. For fighting enemies that rush us down, that's when Mom's Bra gets used, if possible. Got a bomb out of that. That's something. You grow to regret the rerolls, man. Especially on a run that was doing so well. But I have to respect the rerolls as well, you know? Because it's my calling card, without a doubt. It's one of them, at least, you know? Late 90s to early 2000s. One-hit wonder references and re-rolling your run and not giving a damn about it. That's really where I'm at. So, it's my competitive advantage, but it's also the thing that could leave me behind in a situation like this. These enemies rush us down. Apparently, you didn't get hit there, huh? That strikes me as annoying. Definitely need this. Do we care about the boomerang? I was thinking about using Yara there. I don't think the boomerang is good enough. Like, red candle, blue candle, sign me up. Any candle, because black candle might get rid of Curse of the Tower at this point, which would be pretty useful, I think. But the boomerang's not going to kill anything. It'll hurt some things, but it's not going to kill anything. Oh, yeah, okay, that one was 100% my bad. Isaac's heart, you got to stand in there and take those shots. You can't be running away. This should be interesting. It's our second secret room, a golden chest. Second secret room, several pills. Get real tiny like here. Power pills, good to know for the future. Perks is good to know. Although we can't really use it. So we're gonna hold on blank rune. Goathead. Ooh, okay. Goathead Guppy, come on. Oh, the Guppy chances are too high here. This might be a great opportunity to try, like, the Hail Mary pass with the blank rune here. All we'd be hoping for is a blank rune that gives us a Yara or a Purthro. I can't believe we didn't get hit in the process of that right there. Okay, we got Pentagram. I don't think we can fuck with Pentagram. I think we gotta take that. Three red chests. I mean, we can grow in the future here. But it's starting to get a little dangerous, you might be noticing. Go back and get some red chests here. Red hearts, I should say. Alright, life's getting scary, but the Pentagram's a good pickup. This is Perseverance! Let's do it! Stretch it out, get the post-Isaac stretch going right now, because we're gonna have to focus pretty soon. These enemies rush us? Oh, hell yeah, they do. Alright, so, freeze them. Get your rotten babies in action. Fuck Isaac's heart, dude. There's, like, so much ridiculous bullshit that happened on this run so far. It's not over yet, thankfully, but we're almost over now. Almost over now. No, like, the fact that we got conjoined, marked, and Isaac's heart. And, I mean, I guess Isaac's heart contributes to conjoined, but there's just, like, it's a little too many shitty dice rolls in a row, you know? So I'm actually thinking that, like, our best way to get out of this, hilariously, is like another full run reroll. We have to keep this life alive. It's real important. That's not full health. That's health down. Sun card is huge, though. I mean, huger than blank rune, which could be big. The sun card is not to be trifled with here. It's actually so important. So important, I think I'm just going to use blank rune right now. And it just gave me Bracano, so there's no worse time to use it. There's no better time to use it, really. The longer we can go without having to use the sun card, the better our life is going to be here. What the fuck, Isaac's heart? You are the biggest piece of shit. Thanks for the spirit heart, though. Okay, what are other ways around Isaac's heart? Well, considering we have the mom transformation, Nod Leaf is it's a big deal. It's not a big deal. Apart from that, the ability to fly would be it'd be a dang good start. I'm going to be using bombs to pick up HP. Pyromaniac could be extremely important as well. Are we going to do our curse room? Heck yeah, that's like one of the only great things about having Isaac's heart. Free blood bank, which is awesome. And free curse rooms, which can be awesome or neutral. But free blood banks is, most of the time it's a positive, unless you got Bloody Lust or something, I guess. Yeah, that's it. Just gotta keep shooting. It's hard to get in the habit. We gotta keep shooting to keep Robin Baby active here, though. Okay, I mean, this is worth it if we don't get hit. And if we do get hit, it's we broke even. Oh, we got teleported! I mean, what do you do on this guy? Do we really want the second key piece? I mean, I guess we have to, right? I guess we have to say, that we're gonna try to do Mega Satan on this run, because I don't want to anger the Isaac gods. I want the Isaac gods to be pleased with me. That shit is real tough to dodge, when you're dealing with this nonsense, marked, bullshit, ridiculousness. If only you could, like, block beams with Isaac's heart active, you could just run into a beam and block it. Because, like, it's so hard for me to block that shit. It's alright. This is what we got the sun card for. It helps us get through a difficult boss. That's the idea anyway. Honestly, that luck upgrade could end up being worth its weight in gold. This run went from, like, almost, like, zany kind of bragging to, like, we've really got to focus here. What this run is like, I like making the analogies. I guess that's another calling card, but this run is like, you know, we retired at age 65, and we're like average lifespan of a man in Canada is maybe like 85 right now. So you got to survive for 20 years. And you might be saying, well, the average lifespan is actually only 80. Well, yeah, but that takes into account people that are old right now, you know? Like, we'd expect that if I'm going to live until 85, that, I mean, that's going to be 25 years from now. Modern medicine may likely make some advances that extend that average at the point at which I actually reach that. Anyway, you're trying to hit a moving target is what I'm getting at here. But anyway, you should be hit again, as far as I'm concerned. Well, we went into retirement, and it's all well and good. You know, hunky-dory so far. I fucking knew it. Hunky-dory so far. But then, what happens when we live to 100? We're like, oh shit, the money's run out, you know? We gotta do something, so... We got the same amount of HP that we've had for a while, we're just trying to stretch it a little farther, and that's what the Sun card lets us do. The Sun card is like Chapter 11 bankruptcy. It allows us to, get a get-out-of-jail-free card. That's probably a little bit of an ignorant representation of how, bankruptcy works. I honestly have no idea. This room's a little dicey. Other stuff that would be great? I feel like it's almost like a joke, the amount that it comes up lately, but I would not be disappointed to pick up a number two. Like, to be able to just hide in the corner and hopefully bomb some enemies before they can hurt me, that's a big deal. Obviously, really looking forward to the shop and the item room on this floor, so we're gonna go do our due diligence there. And I don't really... Fuck this room, by the way. I don't really expect to never lose this life, but I hope to lose it in a productive fashion. Fuck it, dude. Still, just live to the item room at least. There we go, that's good. Good oh, a double key room! Come on, don't do me dirty. One or six. Ah, okay, it's nothing. It's nothing. That's, life goes on, but it hurts a little bit. I'd be lying if I said it didn't. Come on, get my guppy dream going here. More bombs, more money. Not what I'm looking for, though. Man, like, key bum is definitely not what you want to find out of that shop, I'll tell you that much. Okay, sharp plug, huh? We got placebo? I don't know, Mom's Bra is fairly useful for us right here, but what's our other card? Empress, okay. Placebo, you know it's got the potential to be so good for you. If only it had been blank card instead, we would be rolling, but I don't know. I mean, we could donate, but I'm sort of, like, mad at Planet Earth right now, so I'm not gonna do that. I think Keybagger's picking up all these keys. I'm all for it, honestly, if I can't get to them anyway. Fuck this room. I'd, like, maybe do it like this. Oh my god, we did it. We got away with it too. Alright, how do we do this shit? Dude, a single orbital would mean so much right now as well, but here we are. Just keep Isaac's heart out of the blast radius. How do we do that? I mean, I guess you try for the circles, man. Lucky me. Dry Baby did some good work in there. Can't stand still because real bad. Wait for the foot to come down. That is not the foot coming down. Oh, it is, and Mom's Bra hit nothing. Well, I am trying to use Mom's Bra against Mom, so what was I thinking, right? Like, you can't use that against somebody. Everybody loves the smell of their own brand. Took some damage. The other thing that's bullshit about this run, not that I'm salty, not brackish yet. The other thing that's bullshit about this run, though, is that we rerolled everything but Curse of the Tower stayed. Like, we actually hit, like, 1-1-1-1. We rolled four dice, and we got, like, the one in, you know, 1,800 chance or whatever. What is it? It's 1 in 6 times 6. So it's 1 in 36. And it becomes, like, 1 in, you know, 200 or so, 1 in 12. Yeah, okay, I mean, I'm just doing the rough approximation of the math, but it seems like we weren't grossly incorrect there. We have to use the Sun card. Oh, we don't have to use the Sun card. I can't stress this enough. I don't know where the other HP came from there. But the later we use the Sun card, the better our chances of winning. It just comes down to that, for now at least. And I'm, of course, you know, am I stoked to have picked up the Cancer Trinket? I am over the fucking moon to have picked up the Cancer Trinket. It makes our run so much better. But it's a goddamn cluster truck right here, as is, you know? Marked is already bad enough. This should tell you how I feel about this run. Marked is bad enough that I don't pick it up on a good run. And then we got it on a semi-bad run that is made turbo bad by the fact that the marked crosshair doesn't even actually aim where the shots go. Like, that, the principal strength of marked is, well, at least we know where the shots are going. This is not the case on this run. Okay, this room should be easy enough. Because, you know, we know what these enemies are up to. We know where they're going. We just got to get in there and block the shots. Every heart means a lot. And honestly, I think we've done a pretty good job of handling our shit here. I think we should just freeze these enemies so I don't have to deal with the bounces. Oh, okay. Mom's bra just does not work, which is another... Can I just say that maybe that's definitely in the objectively fucked up reroll camp here? But anyway. I think we've played pretty admirably given the situation here. And that's not me getting ready to make like a concession speech, like at least we tried. I really feel like we're still in this as a result of the fact that haven't really given up here. You know, we looked at our shitty situation, we said this sucks the big one, but let's not roll over and die, let's try to make it happen. And we're trying to make it happen. Every golden chest I open that contains jack shit that's actually useful for me is disappointing. But keep in mind, you know, we do have the goat head. Oh, we have Maggie's bow. Okay, I only noticed that now. I should have noticed it earlier. That's really the first big coup that we've gotten on this run that I feel stoked about. I didn't think I could stop him from getting that. Okay. So the goat head could be big. We got to find the boss, obviously, to make it happen. But the goat head potentially could be pretty enormous for us. Obviously, gotta land that right there. Oh, I still took a hit. But we got a lot of HP just kicking it back here, so... I did take some damage I shouldn't have taken, but life goes on. Hive Mind would be sick. A full run reroll would be pretty sick. Let's see what we got here. More HP, that's valuable. Don't take, in fact, even like use a bomb. Don't take that yet. Every little bit of HP could make the difference here. It's another situation in which you'd probably rather have Mom's bra be active right now, but... We know we're going to get a deal with the devil or angel, and we know we're going to get back to full health. So, like, what do we care? Or unless we take a ton of damage, we're going to get back to full health. So what do we care right now? I guess we're maybe immune to beams if we stand next to the beam. It doesn't matter. Okay, we got toothpicks, which is good. And then the sepulture, or the sensor, sorry. I don't understand this item, but I guess I'm happy to have it. Toothpicks has really raised our rate of fire. And we, you know what, we're leaving to the next floor in a better position, and we still have our sun card with us, which is incredible to me. We got Curse of the Lost. If nothing else, this makes me feel okay about the fact that we don't have mapping items to begin with. The pill is a power pill, that's a good one. Okay, yeah, you know what, why give this guy a chance to mess up our day? Could have given us some HP. Well, he did give us some HP, but I was hoping for the HP container, just to make the sun card that much more valuable, but it's doing good work. If we win this run and we win strongly, I'm gonna be really, really proud of how we got through that valley of shit. Cause we built a summer home in the valley of shit. And we're coming out of it here. Like, we're strong, but also weird. Like, this run is not good. It's too strange to be great right now. Is that two of hearts? That'd be dope. Rules card. Deny his gifts to attain your reward. Really hoping for the full run reroll there, but, sure, no worries. Just so I don't forget where it is, you know, this is a Curse of the Bullshit floor. We might as well walk around, go grab the HP that's up here. We got bombs we can use to freeze some HP in the future, hopefully, but for right now, this is good. Pretty pleased with this. Very disappointed that we had, a little nonsense damage come in there, but it's a tough run right now. Starting to rely on the principle of, like, it's a little easier to aim yourself than it is to aim your shots. Because you're not moving two things at once when you dodge. Seemed to work out okay there. Three bombs, not insignificant. Are you starting to feel the hype of the run? Oh, it snuck by me. I had the best intentions there, and it still snuck by me, but... I'm starting to feel the hype of this run a little bit. Certainly a... Oh, I almost got hit again there. Certainly a little bit of a different Isaac run than usual, but... You know what item... And I normally say, you know, what item would I like to have? Here's an item I would really not like to have right now. Despite the benefits that it would give us... I botched that one. I really would not like to have the soul. because I think that it deflecting shots could lead to me accidentally hitting myself in Isaac's heart by deflecting it off of my own hitbox, which would be like, even if it doesn't happen that often, would be real demoralizing. If you're like, oh, I hit myself like an idiot. So much HP. That's great news. Again, if we can bring the sun card down to the chest, do we win? I don't know. The chest is a cruel mistress, but it's at least a start. Oh my god, these eternal hearts as well. And every streak has to have runs like this. It's just, like, statistically, it's gonna happen. You're gonna have to get through these situations if you want to get to those, you know, even mid-double-digit streaks. So, I think we're doing just fine right now. Just pretty as a picture. Not fully surprised we got hit twice there. It's a bit of a moment of truth. Just block the shots. Watch out for the beams, but you gotta block the shots if possible. That sucks. We don't want to use the sun card here because we can get back to full health. If we have to use the sun card, we have to. Like, don't sweat that. He just created so much more health. We gotta use the sun card. I hate to do it. It's gotta be done. Isaac's heart's immune to beams. Maybe we didn't have to use it, but I felt like we had to. I don't feel bad about it. You gotta go Dark Bomb here, right? The 1 HP is well worth the cost. Betrayal is not worth it, though. Okay. And we're really gonna be doing our due diligence here, so... Red hearts, please. Oh, look at that. It's like a free spirit heart right there. Of course, we're gonna be the number one priority because we have, we have Maggie's bow. You gave me a spider for that shit. But, we definitely want those spirit hearts out of Dark Bum as well. Excuse me, speed up, please. Alright, well, what's the next, what's our next options? Really, we're gonna have 7 HP and a spirit heart. Well, yeah, I thought we would have 8, but we did take Dark Bum. We're gonna have 7 HP and a spirit heart backing us up. We gotta play pretty well. We do have 9 lives, but I don't really want to fight Blue Baby on 1 HP. Like, with this setup, at least, it strikes me as a little hellish. Curse of the Maze, not necessarily that bad. Remember, you want to block the shots. If they rush you, you're in a tough spot, but if they're not rushing you, just do what you did right there. Get in front of the shots. Nicely done. Nicely done. This guy could be a real jerk, so... We're gonna freeze him up, and then we're gonna body block in front of him. Ah, he tore through the block. He's like a piece of iron. Half a heart, that belongs to me. I don't want the spirit heart. I want full HP, and then it goes to Dark Bomb to grab it. Na 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 na. Here comes the stream ender. It's a real wanker. See, wanker is one of those words that does not sound right when a person who is not from, like, the British Isles says it. Do you say wanker in Australia? I think it might be, like, slightly outside of the normal parlance. Oh, that one was actually... I have no problem taking 100% responsibility for that shot. I should have moved out of the way there faster so that Isaac's heart didn't get caught. It is nice to know that, like, what's this? Health down, that's a good one. It's actually not bad, because we're going to get, if we die, we're gonna get 9 lives. So each life is only gonna have 1 HP, so we can give 1 life 2 HP. Give me some HP so I can see what's in this room right now. I forgot what I was saying earlier. It doesn't matter that much right now. All that matters is actually getting the job done. That's the good stuff right there. I'd rather you didn't take the half heart, honestly. It's a tough call. I don't know about that one. No. That belongs to me, if possible. Okay, you're not supposed to dodge out of the way of shots. I'm gonna let that one pass because you succeeded, but that's not the way you want it to go most of the time. Yes, we never die. Oh, we multiply. Mostly thanks to the fact I picked up 9 lives. Here comes the stream ender. Turn it up. It's a real shitty reroll. Excuse me, Mr. Edmonds. Still got it like Dan. Here comes the meme master. All right. People know that song, right? We've been talking about it on the NLSS. I didn't invent the song. I was like 6 when it came out. I'm just bringing it back. It's a great song. Come on, chameleon. You come and go. No more bums. We got Dark Bum already. Brain's starting to get scrambled from all this concentration required. Oh, that 2 hits there is not acceptable. Getting real low. That's alright, we got 1 full heart coming back to us. I do expect the Isaac fight is gonna be- Oh, come on. Isaac's heart, you're a real dick, you know that? Oh, dude, thank you so much. Without Maggie's bow, this run, I think the burn rate's just too high. I think we go down. Maggie's bow is attempting to save us. Is it gonna succeed? I don't know, man. I just don't know. It's not, it just ain't right to have a full run reroll screw you like that. If we're gonna go, oh god, full on absurd here. You know what I wanna see? I wanna see the wafer. Let's make this a full on war of attrition. I'm ready. Also, like Bloody Penny would be awesome. Oh my, this is just absurd. Let me into the room. Oh, so good, okay. What do you think? You think we got a second secret room right here? Gotta check, right? Just get as much damage in as you can. Alright, is there a place where like we can stand? First things first, you need to actually hit the fucking bullets. What? The curved bullets. It is bad. The thing I want to point out that is really bad right now is that I can't stop shooting. As much as I would like to... Okay, that's pretty good. As much as I would like to create a situation in which I maybe just go into that Isaac fight and exclusively use bombs, there's no, like, end game for me on it, because I can't stop shooting. I'm really, like, I'm hemmed in, let's put it that way. This is actually potentially pretty big. Because there... Oh, I thought the knife would get him in time, and it did in the end. I almost don't want a great pill because we could have had placebo. I guess we could have had placebo health down, but placebo health down is not that incredible. So I can get in there and like only place bombs, even though they're only base bombs anyway. But I don't think there's anything I can do about that. Like. I'm actually, to be honest with you, I'm like a little bitter over this. Because I feel like the game fucked me this time. And that's not the agreement that the game and I have set out. We have a collaborative agreement where we work together to provide entertainment. And this time, it's really like... I don't know if we leave that and just use it with our full health pill to try to live. Okay, this is not where you should be at this point. We should not be in this room anymore. I'm gonna open the chests first. And any HP that drops here, I can't do anything about, so you might as well take it. Okay. Then do we double down? Do we just go for the HP upgrade after we leave this room? If only I didn't have to use that sun card on the mom's heart fight, man. I saw it coming. I saw it coming a mile away. I still couldn't do anything about it. Just get focused, guys. Here comes the run ender. I'm not gonna bend. Please give me ascendance. Still love it like that. Yeah, I'm gonna be slightly brackish if. Oh my lord, it wasn't that funny. I'm gonna be slightly brackish if we end up losing this one because we really met the game more than halfway here. And then they have chosen to reward me with punishment, which there should be a word for that. I'm joking, but I hate this as well. I don't know that I've ever seen a reroll as uniformly terrible as this, but maybe I'm just projecting because I'm inside of it right now, you know? Okay, so you're on half a heart action right now. Found our eternal heart. We know that there's a full heart in here. You know what? Pick it up. Pick it up and give me a spirit heart. You're the man. You're actually keeping me alive here. I respect that. I appreciate that. I'm still wondering how the fuck we're gonna beat Blue Baby. Or, well, yes, but also how the fuck we're gonna beat Isaac. We could get super lucky and just not... I don't even remember what I was gonna say. Not get hit, I guess. But, you know, this is huge. This tarot card potential is huge. Why am I not popping health up yet? I'm just trying to, you know, it's better to have cards in hand than to put your cards on the table if the game's not settled yet, you know? Any information that we have that has not been used yet is an asset. So there's always a way out in Isaac. Question is, can we finagle it? If only, man. If only. That sucks. It's really bad. I don't even know if that'll shoot straight at this point. Block the shots. Shoot the J. Shoot it. You know what? We have a battery charge available, so pop this shit. Oh, I forgot. Mom's Bra just doesn't work most of the time. Sweet, thanks. That's not Balls of Steel, but I mean, I'm thankful for the spiders, I guess. That's beautiful. So we're locked in here now. You know what? Fuck it. Let's fight this room. This could end up being a pretty pivotal decision. Stay away from me, please. There's too many of them. I say this could be a pivotal decision because, you know, if we get Mr. Mega, that's big news. If we lose HP, which we already have, that's big news as well, but for all the wrong reasons. But maybe bombs are an alternate win condition we can pursue here. And of course, any chance to get a red heart or a spirit heart. I'm letting Dark Bomb take the full red hearts, because if I use the health upgrade pill, I only need a half red heart. We got two bombs for our troubles. That's what we got on that room, just for the record. We got two bombs. Three bombs, maybe? Oh, this is potentially big. Okay, you can take that. I mean, I don't really want it anyway, of course. What am I going to do with an extra half heart, despite, you know, what I just mentioned to you? Sweet! Alright, this is interesting, because we actually have two eternal hearts now. Which we should not pick up the other one yet. In fact, we shouldn't have picked up that one yet. Why not pick up the other one yet? I hope that's fairly obvious. It'll fuck up the health down pill. Come on, work it, baby. Give me a sun card. Karma. It's not good enough without Mom's purse. Okay. Stay frosty. This is, by the way, I can't stress this enough. This is the easy part. Shit's about to get to the hard part. Yes, that's for you. You the man. Okay. I mean, we have to go for this now. How am I going to get one extra half red heart out of this, though? Because I kind of fucked that. I mean, I really don't want to do the Gertie Jr. room.
Do, 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 do. Yes, we multiply.
You got a pill in here, but what is it? It's range down. That's not good enough. There's like no other. We've already been to the secret rooms. There's some kind of trinket in there. I guess we could use the health down, possibly with karma, get a health up pill. Excuse me, streamer. I guess we just gotta go for it. This is really all of our eggs in this basket right now. So you grab that, rewind it back. Should have more HP right now. I fucked that up. There's no other way for us to make it happen, though. So, I mean, basically at this point, just be strong, you know? There we go. Just back Isaac's heart up to the point where hopefully Dark Bum is in front of it. Or not Dark Bum. Oh, fuck. We fucked it. I'm not even, like, hitting at all. And neither is Run, baby, which is the most disappointing part of all. There we go. We almost hit for a second there. I don't think I can do it. Like, I'm trying my damnedest here, y'all. I got to accept it. I think we've been bested. And it really bums me out, because there is a win here. There is a win on this run. I'm certainly not doing it right now. But we had it, and that's going to be the streak. That hurts. I'm actually, like, the negative emotions are flooding into me right now. I'm feeling pretty bad, but I tried. That's what I get for trying to keep my trademark brand of zaniness, I guess. This, by the way, this is just a perfect synopsis of what this run is like right now. What if we tilt it 45 degrees, so we're shooting at him, and then, no, it just will not work. There's nothing we can do about it at this point. We could try to fight Gertie Jr., but we're gonna get hit here. We could try one last war of attrition like this. I'm doing my damnedest to box it in, but the shots are coming in on all sides, you know? And of course, this guy's gonna start to move pretty soon and create other enemies. This is how we should have done it when we had more HP. But no, the shot still got in. That's a really shitty way for the streak to end, and I apologize. But, I mean, I didn't fuck up anything except going to the reroll room, which is just trademark Northern Lion. But for now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it in spite of the streak ending. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.